creating turmoil and saluting injustice. And if we're not a part of the solution, then we're a part of the problem. And with problems being stacked on top of problems, way too many unbothered and not enough trying to solve them, but the ones who are trying to solve them become the focus of attacks from these social media activists and these keyboard critics. Of running from the sweat that will be trickling down the backs of our soldiers, afraid that they'll be a target. Now, if I point one finger at you, I got three pointing back at me. So I have to be honest and say that that used to be my mentality. But what happened, kings, to I am my brother's keeper? Queens, I am my sister's defense. What happened to standing on the fence and protecting our kin, no matter how trying it gets? See, we should be uncomfortable with the way the world is becoming because there's blood on our hands if we continue to do nothing. Pontius Pilate tried to scrub his, but he still felt the remnants, cold sweats, sleepless nights, ricochet bullets filled with hate and lies, body cavities being pumped with the elements of gunpowder. Our kids are being assassinated every second, every minute, every hour. But where are our heroes? Because see, heroes don't have to wear a cape. I came here tonight to stare a few heroes in the face. Make no mistake, see, this is not a debate. This war, this era we're in, is not a spectator sport. The lessons that should be learned should be gotten at home and not when the judge bangs the gavel in court. Now I'm teaching my children to be strong. I vote for change. And insanity is the definition of doing the same thing and getting the same results. So I think I need to do something that's not the same. Change. There's blood on our hands if we do nothing. How many times are you going to scrub away the blood until you realize there's still a stain? No more bloodshed. Adam's.